Hi, friends. I'm Emily Lay, and you're listening to the Simplified Podcast. If you want to let go of perfection so you can enjoy this season at your own pace, then welcome. I'm glad you're here. Every week, I invite you to slow down and join me to explore practical ways to organize and automate the complicated parts of life so you can focus on what truly matters most. Friends, the holidays are inching closer. And if you're still looking for a gift that's perfect for a friend, your mom, a sister, and will also arrive on time before the big day, you can get her a Simplified gift card. You can print it out, it's so cute, and tuck it into a sweet card or a stocking filled with chocolates. Or you can send her a gift card straight to her email and tell her which Simplified products you love that you think she'd like to. Go ahead and check those gifts off your list. You can get a Simplified gift card right now at emilylay.com. I have one vice in this world, gummy bears. Okay, maybe I have two vices, gummy bears and books. I love books. I always have. Ever since I could pick up a book and read for myself, getting lost in a story has been one of the greatest joys of my life. When I was a kid, reading was the way I entered worlds that went far beyond my bedroom door in little Pensacola, Florida. I could romp around on a sunny day with the wild Ramona Quimby, or hunt for clues around the big city with Harriet the Spy, or fall into a wardrobe all the way to Narnia and trudge through the cold, crunchy snow with Lucy and Aslan and Mr. Tumnus. I saw how choosing love or fear could lead you down completely different paths. I saw how many times a villain is just really a broken person living out their pain, desperate to keep other people at arm's length so they won't get hurt anymore. I saw how families could look different from mine, and the bonds of love were just as tight. I saw that family is made up of the people you choose. I learned how much courage it takes to exchange the story you know for the uncertainty of one that's still unfolding. Books have taught me what I value in myself and others, and have helped me to keep reaching to be the best version of myself. On my best days, books have honed and shaped what I believe to be true, like a sword to a whetstone, and helped me make bold choices that reflect those beliefs. And on the harder days, books are the brain break that help me relax into the rest my body needs so that I can get up tomorrow and try again. These are the tools I also want for my children. I want them to have access to a portal that helps them learn about themselves and the world around them. I've read to each of them since they were babies, and one by one, I've watched them fall in love with the power of a good story. I've watched their eyes light up as they've peeked through windows into different lives and choices and places and relationships. They get to practice being human before it's time for them to go into the world and make mistakes on their own. And they'll make mistakes, just like we all do. But maybe they'll have the muscle memory of a story that told them to value the strength of their convictions over pressure to please someone else. Or that choosing love is sometimes so much harder than choosing to give in to fear, but in the end, it's worth it. As a mother, that's what I hope for anyway. I know that this time of year, we're thinking about what to give the kids in our lives. More than ever, I'm really into the idea that less is more, even for my kids. I think they're better off learning that joy is easier to find when you rely less on what's going on around you and paying attention to nurturing what's inside you. I've always admired this giving framework during the holidays. It's the idea that you give a kid four things: something you want, something you need, something to wear, something to read. Not surprisingly, I love giving books to our kids, and even to their friends on their birthdays. And if you'd like to give the gift of a story to the little ones in your life this year, I have a few favorites I'd like to share with you. First, let's talk about a few picture books for little ones who are around ages 3 to 6. Number one, Rabbit's New Rug by Judy Delton. This was one of my favorite books when I was a kid. Now, it may not be at your local bookstore because it's kind of old, but it's definitely on Amazon, and the storyline is so me. It captured who I was even when I was little. So here's the story. Rabbit gets a brand new rug. It's colorful. It has little tulips and daisies on it, and he's really excited about it, so excited that he wants to invite all his friends over to see it. But then he starts thinking about what will happen to the rug if he invites people over, and it accidentally gets dirty. He thinks about baking, but worries what will happen if he bakes and gets flour all over the rug. He decides to keep the good news about the rug all to himself, but then he gets lonely. Does that sound familiar? In the end, Rabbit realizes he loves his people more than his new rug, and he'll show it to them even if it gets a little dirty in the process. What a great reminder for kids and adults. I still love this book. Also, here's a fun fact. The illustrations are by Mark Brown, who wrote and illustrated the Arthur series. So you might recognize some of the illustration style in the book. Okay, number two, An Awesome Book of Thanks by Dallas Clayton. I love all of Dallas Clayton's books. They're so good. They're sweet and simple, simple enough for a three-year-old to understand, but every single one of his books teaches kids about how to be a big-hearted human, even from a young age. They show kids how to dream big, love big, and have a thankful heart. This book does more of the latter. It shows kids how to say thank you for the world around them. It introduces them to the concept that the world didn't always look like it did today. It didn't have things like boats and cars, even people and stars. And for all the things we have, we can say thank you. This book is simple but powerful and makes you say, wow, even as an adult. Plus, the colors and illustrations are bold and absolutely gorgeous. You should pick up any and all of Dallas Clayton's kids' books. They are amazing. Okay, number three, Big Plans by Bob Shea and illustrated by Lane Smith. My kids are obsessed with this book. It is so cleverly written. The illustrations are ridiculous. They're just so good. The story has a rhythm to it that'll stay with you and makes reading so much fun. This picture book teaches kids in the most fun way how to dream big and has a twisty, windy plot with If You Give a Mouse a Cookie vibes. It is so funny, the illustrations are ingenious, and it's insanely quotable. My kids are always saying the catchphrase from the book, I've got big plans, I say. It's a favorite in our house, and if anybody says they have a plan, my kids will recite back that line. Okay, next let's talk about some chapter books for bigger kids. So number four on our list, the Harry Potter series by J.K. Rowling. Brady Lay is already obsessed with Harry Potter books, and I don't blame him. I'm not sure you could do much better than an epic tale of the power of love and friendship with a bit of magic and mischief woven in. If you're new to the world of Harry Potter, start with Harry Potter and the Sorcerer's Stone. Around age 8 or 9 is the perfect place to begin. There are a couple other chapter books that we love in the Lay House, like Diary of a Wimpy Kid series and the Wayside School series, both of which are hilarious. The Magic Treehouse series, I think we own every single copy of every single book. And of course, The Chronicles of Narnia. Okay, there is a movie. Obviously, there's movies for a lot of these books, but there is a Chronicles of Narnia, The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe movie, and it is so beautiful and so well done. I highly recommend reading the book first and then watching the movie with your kids, but that is a favorite thing of ours to do during the holidays, is to watch that movie. Okay, next, I want to share one of my very favorite Bible storybooks with you. This is number five on our list. The Jesus Storybook Bible by Sally Lloyd-Jones. If you buy one Bible storybook for the kids in your life, make it this one. And if you've already got one, buy this one anyway. It's a completely different type of kids Bible or Bible storybook than I've ever seen because it weaves together all the big stories of the Bible, both the Old Testament and the New, into one cohesive story that God sent Jesus to rescue us. And every story in the Bible is centered around that truth. I've read the Jesus Storybook Bible cover to cover with each of my kids. It's such a good introduction to faith and the Bible. And not only that, Sally's writing it's written like the best sort of fairy tale, one that makes you laugh and stirs your soul even when you're 38 years old. She's even just started a podcast around the book too, which you should totally check out. I can't recommend this one enough. And every little story is just a couple pages, and it's the perfect bedtime book to work through, like every night. It's a treasured memory for me of reading each one of those pages with my kids. So highly recommend. Okay, now for a couple bonus books, or bonus favorites, if you will. For baby shower gifts, I love giving new mamas a picture book called The Wonderful Things You Will Be by Emily Winfield Martin. I love everything about this book. It is told from the perspective of a parent looking at a child and dreaming what this small little person will do when they grow up. I mean, I can honestly, like, I can hardly talk about it without choking up because it gives me all the feelings. It will for you as well. Anyway, it's a beautiful gift to give to a new parent. And one more for older kids around 8 to 12. Last year, I was so excited to release Grace Not Perfection in a young reader's edition. I knew how much I needed Grace Not Perfection, the original book, as an adult, and I had my daughter Caroline in mind when I adapted that message for tween girls. Like I said, as a little girl, I was like Rabbit in Rabbit's New Rug. I wanted everything to be perfect, even when keeping things perfect was costing me my heart, and I didn't even know it. I wanted Caroline to learn that lesson much earlier than I did, that you don't have to be perfect to be enough, and that your heart receives so much more when you keep it open and let people see the bumps and bruises, that you don't have to do more to be loved. It's a book of my heart, this one. If there's a tween girl in your life who needs this message, then she might enjoy Grace Not Perfection for young readers. Okay, so I did a teensy bad job at narrowing my list to just 5 books, but it's hard. Books are amazing, and as long as I live, I will never stop being a reader. I will never stop being a learner, and I want to train my kids to be the same way. As we close out this episode, I would like to say a little blessing for you as we leave this time together and get back into our days. May you listen to the stories that move you, that make you think, that make your heart soar or break. May you point your younger ones to tales that do the same. May you model the courage to keep your heart open so that stories different from your own can find their way in, so that little ones can see a new way to think, to dream, to live, to love. And as always, I like to leave a little tip to help you put what we've talked about today into practice. So here's your task for this week. When I was little, I loved a good book on tape. And now that's morphed into an obsession with audiobooks. If you're looking for some kid-friendly audiobooks for bedtime or in the car, you've got to check out the Hoopla app. Hoopla works directly with your local library to offer all kinds of stuff for free, all kinds of music, TV shows, and yes, especially audiobooks. They have a huge selection of kids' audiobooks on there, so if you're traveling for the holidays, now's a good time to stock up on Hoopla, especially since it's free. Thank you for listening to the Simplified Podcast. Whether you're a mom, a cool aunt, a grandma, or a really great friend, I hope today's episode inspired you to share some wonderful stories with the kids in your life. You can find every single book I mentioned here in the show notes for this episode at emilylay.com/podcast, where you can check out links and resources I mentioned here, and you can shop the Simplified brand of planners and products. Plus, for more simplicity tips, you can find me on Instagram at emilylay and at simplified. And if you're loving this show, then I bet you might like my latest book called Growing Boldly, Dare to Build a Life You Love, which is in stores right now wherever you buy books. I love seeing how these episodes are resonating with you when you rate and review the show. I read every single review and take what you are saying to heart. If you haven't already, would you consider leaving a rating and a review? That helps our show find its way to new listeners. And don't forget to hit that subscribe or follow button on your podcast provider so you can get the show right on your phone each week without even thinking about it. Talk about automation at its finest. Okay, friends, that's it for now. Till next time, thank you so much for listening. Bye.